next song I wrote around the turn of the century. Mindless own business on my own record, and suddenly got took up by a big duo in Nashville called Brooks and Dunn. And they had a number one hit with this song. But it nearly didn't happen, you know, because my publisher came to me at one point and he says, "Paul, they want to change the words." And I said, "Oh, yeah." Right. Tell me more. Well, you know, you see, this is a song about a couple who, well, this is one of the interpretations, so I'm very reluctant to put a finite interpretation on a song because people can read whatever they want into it. But it was about a couple who loved each other madly, but they just couldn't get on. And it was like, they kept trying to put it together, but it was always falling apart. And the chorus goes, this is the man singing, right? "No matter how hard we try, you're going to make me cry." And I says, "Okay, so they want to change that?" And he says, "Yeah. You see, in Nashville, real men don't cry." So they want to say, "No matter how hard we try, I always make you cry." So it goes like, "Well, is that all right, Paul?" And I'm sort of like, "Okay." And then I went to number one, you see. So it pays to shut up sometimes. Anyway, it's a song called "A Long Goodbye."
Tears me up inside just to think we still could try.